हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज़ हातिम रामपुर वाला एंड इन दिस वीडियो वी विल बी रिवाइजिंग अ फ्यू इलस्ट्रेशन एंड टेस्ट योर नॉलेज ऑफ इंड एस 105. वी वुड नॉट बी डिस्कसिंग ऑल बट या फ्यू ऑफ देम. इफ़ यू वॉन्ट सम अदर इलस्ट्रेशन ऑल्सो नीड्स टू बी डिस्कस्ड, यू कैन कमेंट इट बिलो इन द कमेंट सेक्शन. ओके, सो लेट्स डिस्कस. सो फर्स्ट वील टेक इलस्ट्रेशन, वेट अ सेकेंड, वट हैपन, वील फर्स्ट डिस्कस इलस्ट्रेशन वन. वेर इज इलस्ट्रेशन वन? या इलस्ट्रेशन वन. मेजरमेंट प्रायर टू द क्लासिफिकेशन एज हेल्ड फॉर सेल. सो वॉट वुड बी द मेजरमेंट प्रायर टू द क्लासिफिकेशन एज हेल्ड फॉर सेल? वी हैव टू प्योरली ब्रिंग इट टू द कॉस्ट आफ्टर डिडक्टिंग एंटायर डेप्रिसिएशन टिल द डेट ऑफ क्लासिफिकेशन. सो दैट्स वॉट ऑन दैट कॉन्सेप्ट द सम हैज बीन बेस्ड. दैट इज एन आइटम ऑफ द प्रॉपर्टी प्लांट एंड इक्विपमेंट दैट इज मेजर्ड एट द कॉस्ट बेसिस शुड बी मेजर्ड इन द अकॉर्डिंग विद इंड एस 16. एन एंटिटी ए बी सी लिमिटेड ओन्स एन आइटम ऑफ द प्रॉपर्टी एंड इट वॉज स्टेटेड एट द following amount in its last financial statement, and it was stated in the last financial statement 31st December. So the closing date is 31st December for the company. Then cost is 12 lakh rupees, depreciation is 6 lakh, and net book value is 36 lakh rupees. Okay, now net book value is 6 lakh. The asset is depreciated at an annual rate of 1,20,000 per annum during July 2002, that is next year in July. That is basically we have to consider end of July, that is 31st July till 31st July. Entity ABC Limited decided to sell the asset on 1st August. Okay, it meets the condition to be classified as held for sale on 1st August. It meets the condition, so till 31st July we have to depreciate the asset and bring down the value of the asset after deducting the depreciation. And on 1st August, it meets the classification as held for sale. Analyze. So we'll quickly go through the answer as well. So it is simple basically. 1,20,000 is full year depreciation. We have to calculate 7 month depreciation, that is 70,000, and that we will deduct from that 6 lakh rupees. So 5,30,000 will be the cost on that. 5,30,000 will measure as per Ind AS 105. At 31st July, entity ABC Limited should measure that, and ABC Limited should ensure on 31st July, entity ABC Limited should ensure that the asset is measured in accordance with Ind AS 16. So it should be properly measured as per Ind AS 16. That is, depreciation should be charged till date. It should depreciated by further 70,000, 1,20,000 into 7/12, and should be carried at 5,30,000 before. It should be measured at 5,30,000 before it is measured in accordance with 105. Note, from the date of the asset is classified as held for sale, no further depreciation will be charged. So further after this held for sale is been classified, that is 5,30,000, no depreciation will be charged. Okay, now we'll solve next sum. Which next sum to be solved? Illustration number 3. What is this? Yeah, it is just a format. Illustration 2, illustration 3. Yeah, Sun Limited is a retailer of takeaway food like burger, pizza. It decided to sell one of its outlet located in Chandni Chowk in Delhi. The company will continue to run 200. So it has decided to sell one outlet and the company will continue to run 200 other outlet in New Delhi. All India's 105 criteria are as held for sale are classified as held for sale classification were first met on 1st October 2001. The outlet will be sold in June 2002. Management believed that the outlet is a discontinued operation and want to present the result of the outlet as and want to present the result of the outlet as the discontinued operation. So management is of the belief that the outlet is a discontinued operation and want to present the result outlet as a discontinued operation analyze. So it is not a discontinued operation, it has just closed one outlet. So it is a disposal group. It will be classified as disposal group, that is Chandni Chowk outlet which it is about to close. That is a disposal group and not a discontinued operation, as it is only one outlet. It is not a major line of business. So it is not a major line of business, nor geographical area, nor subsidiary acquired for the purpose acquired with a view to resale. So it is a disposal group. Then which illustration? Next is, we'll do test your knowledge, question number 2. Second test your knowledge. See, already I said we are discussing only few illustration. If you want, for instance, that I should discuss third test your knowledge as well, so you can comment it below. Else we will be discussing a few only in this revision section, revision session. Okay. On 1st March, NTTR decides to sell one of its factories. An agent is appointed and the factory is actively marketed. So what the question is stated is, on 1st March, NTTR decides to sell one of its factory. So it is deciding to sell one of its factory. Entity, an agent is appointed and the factory is actively marketed. As on 31st March, it is expected that the factory will be sold by 20th February. So by the closing, it is expected that the factory will be sold by 20th February 2002, that is within the period of 12 months from the end of the closing period. Closing is 31st March 1 and it is 28th February 2002, that is approx in 11 month time, which is less than 12 month. However, in May 2001, the market price of the factory deteriorates. NTTR believed that the market will recover and thus will not reduce the price of the factory. Company accounts are authorized for issue on 26th June. Should the factory be accounted as held for sale as on 1? Yes, it will be accounted as held for sale, because before closing period there wasn't any such event, so it will be still classified because that event occurred after the balance sheet date. Okay, so we'll quickly read the answer. In this example, the factory ceases to meet the definition as held for sale post the balance sheet date. So it is violating the criteria to meet the definition of held for sale post the balance sheet date, but before the financial statement are authorized for issue, as it is not actively marketed at a reasonable price. It should have been marketed at a reasonable price, but it is, as it is after balance sheet and before approval of financial statement, but though it is after balance sheet, not prior to balance sheet, but since the market condition deteriorates post the balance sheet, the basic condition is, since the market condition deteriorates post balance sheet date, asset will be classified as held for sale as on 31st March. So it will not affect any classification as on 31st March. It will still be classified as asset held for sale, and even though before approval, entity is of the knowledge that the market value is deteriorated and asset is not marketed at reasonable market value, but then too, since the event has occurred after the balance sheet date, what we'll do is, entity will retain its classification, that is asset will be classified as held for sale as on 31st March 2001. Okay, so we are done with this. Thank you for watching the video.